I think we're back. I think we might be back. We have a fantastic guest with us. We did stop streaming for a moment, but I think we're back.
We're back?
I think, yes, we're back, bro.
We're back?
We're back, just in time.
Oh my days, and we've got our guest.
One and Indepaul's here. Yeah.
You've been on the channel before.
She has been on the channel before.
Oh my.
Yeah, I know, it's been a bit of a roller coaster.
How come the camera's on me when the way I sat down was a bit awkward? I didn't look right when I was sitting down there.
To your right, Indepaul.
Oh, he's changing.
Oh, he's changing?
Yeah.
He's changing his clothes.
Oh yeah, he wants to look like a superstar, bro.
Okay. Dun, 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 dun,
dun, dun. I mean, I'm just not trying to look like an Eskimo, that's all. It's very cold outside.
Oh, for real? Right. Okay, okay. I hear you. Bro, bring your superstar look.
Bring that ass over here, boy. You guys are really... Let's let the people flood back
bro,
in.
Bro, you best look like... what you're doing, you best look fly, bro. You best look at this guy.
How you doing, my man? Indepaul is back. That's you, by the way. That mic's you. You want to hear that?
All right.
You just got to hold it. Hold it. Yeah, yeah.
Sorry, folks. Yes, we're back. Christopher Jordan, we are back. Heather, we are back. Let's go.
Let us get the ball rolling.
Just in case this might happen again, please stay
that's
in
good,
there.
Actually.
We'll keep coming back. We'll keep coming back. We are not finishing until we're done with this album. That's how we're running.
We can't be stopped. How are you doing, Indepaul?
Yeah, what are you saying?
Oh, we can't hear you.
I'm there. Okay. How are we saying? Live. How we doing? Yeah, big up all the viewers and happy new year. Shout out to your moms. All right. We're in the place. Yep.
Oh my.
What?
Bro, it's not cold enough. You have to leave the thing open, bro.
I thought we did that on purpose.
Oh, do you know what? I'll close it. Introduce the Indepaul to the people.
Oh, okay.
I'll do it.
Peoples, this is Indepaul Sandu.
I don't even know where I'm looking.
Look at you. Bro, you know what? I never know where I'm looking at any time.
That sounded quite philosophical still.
It is. And this guy, always be telling you that, don't come, you're too close to the camera, you're too close to the
microphone.
You
need someone like that though, man.
He's annoying to the first level. To the highest level, I should say.
Okay, I don't want to get involved in this.
Okay.
Keep me out.
Hey, look at this guy.
Yeah, man, got my own thing.
He's got to get a promo. You got to get a promo.
You feel me? Come on.
All right.
Let's give the people what they want anyway.
Guys, we're going back in. Let's go. Wait, we was on Rain When I Die.
Can you guys quickly fill me in or is it too late? Am I too late?
All right. Okay, so basically we're going through Alice in Chains. You know much about Alice in Chains?
Yeah, man. Chains and Alice still.
Oh, for real?
Pick them up. Come on.
Oh yeah.
I don't. But shout out to them.
Okay, so anyway, they were or are a grunge sort of act. You know, as you know, like Nirvana, the Pearl Jam, these. You know, they were very much at the highest at that time. You know. At that era of time, and we're gonna go through their legendary album.
All right, Alice in Chains.
Alice in Chains. All right, let's go. So this is Rain When I Die. Right, halfway through.
Oh, let's start. We start from the top. Yeah,
you want to?
Yeah, we have to start from the top.
This is foolish.
Okay, cool.
Bring it up now. Bring it up. How's it sounding for you?
Can I get it higher?
Oh my days. Scott Mukumba said, I think the video is a second or two behind the audio.
Oh really?
Yes.
Need people like Scott, you know.
I'm telling you,
Scott's keeping you on track. You know what I'm saying?
Scott says, I don't know what's happening.
It's a bit like the music.
Maybe it's just Scott.
Scott, don't have it. Defend yourself. Defend yourself, Scott. You won the title. very ghoulish.
Is anybody else having this kind of issue? I guess everybody would, really, to be honest.
Thank you, Jesse.
Heather says at least the live hasn't dropped out.
Oh, so it's true?
Yeah.
The audio's lagging?
Yeah. Christopher Jordan said it slightly off. Sorry guys, trial and error with this thing.
First live that you done?
No, first live doing a full album.
Okay, appreciate the drinks.
Oh yeah. Jordan said it's not distracting though. Okay, okay. You know what, it's better than us locking off and trying to do it again. I think we should just power through it.
The audience is very reassuring.
I know,
and we do not feel.
Thank you guys, thank you, thank you.
Such a nice break from like the ghoulish sound that they have. Oh, when that chorus comes in, it just it breaks it up very nicely. That's more.
I hear you, I hear you, man.
And the melodies were there, really cool, man.
You know, I would think you'd like some this tune in particular.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
This is a bit of you, isn't it, with that distortion?
Oh yeah.
That's a bit of you, right?
Oh yeah, yeah, of course, all the way.
What's the drum saying to you, JB?
I like it. I like it. I like it. I like the drums. I like it now. I didn't like it before.
Yeah.
I didn't like it before I started listening to rock. I think now I appreciate it because I know what they're trying to do. Whereas before it was like...
Oh.
what they're trying to do. They still
or what they've done. What they're doing. Shots fired. Shots fired. I can see what they're doing. Yeah. Do you know what it's like listening to? When you listen to different styles of music, your ears get so tuned to that sound of drums and guitar and stuff like that. So imagine you just listen to acoustic music. When you hear distortion, you're like, "What's that? That sounds
Where's
loud."
Where's it come
and,
from?
Yeah. So no, I like the drums. I like the song is okay. It's still using. Do you know what?
It's still using the brush.
It's still cohesive though. Right. The album is. If you're listening to it from start to finish, you're like, okay, it's kind of flowing from song to song to song. But it's yeah. That's all I'll say for now. Because we're listening to it on a whole, so I'm judging it on a whole. You know, I haven't really been able to pick out any lyrics or anything like that, or anything, any meanings of songs. But
How many songs have we spun already?
This is the third one.
That's the third song.
The third one.
Okay.
What was your take?
I liked it, man. I think I understand what you were saying about the drums in a sense that you'd expect it to go mad at some points, but they're like they're filling like pockets or they're finding their spots. I hear that. But I like because it starts hella ghoulish, like really like, you know, some like somebody's chasing you somewhere in the alleyway, and then the chorus just breaks up into like a niceness, you know what I mean? Like this. It mellows out, you know. It gets a bit romantical, if you like.
I like the difference in the
but I really like what they done with their voice, though. Like you can hear where they've layered it.
Yeah,
they try to add
the
melody and stuff to that. That really adds to the ghoulish.
Ghoulish
is my word for this too.
Ghoulish.
Wow.
I hear the ghoulishness of it. To be honest, I do hear the ghoulishness.
I think the chorus. In it, like, you know, I'm noticing, even though I kind of knew the pattern but I'm getting reminded of the pattern of them doing the whole harmonies in that verse and then they leave the one man for the chorus. Okay, no harmonies here, leave him, go. And
he does his thing
and whatever, and then they all come, you know, then he comes back in for the verse. But
one thing I'll say as well is that they are following this rhythm to
What you're doing is trash. You call yourself a drummer, bro.
Oh, wow. That's the rhythm they're using on everything so far. Do the pattern.
Well, maybe that's not it.
They're using that a lot.
I guess he is a drummer after all. You know? But still,
what are people saying?
All right, what are people
are they still saying?
Saying
it's lagging? I don't know why it's lagging. I can't figure it out.
But they're living with it.
Ask them, is it still lagging? And ask them what's their opinions. Let's see what people are saying.
All right. Let me see. The city and color cover of this is amazing. Oh, okay. Somebody else done a cover of this. If you guys haven't heard it, you should check it out. Okay. All right. Heather said that. Def giving it a listen. You described grunge perfectly. Ooh.
Who?
I guess I did.
It might have been Hinderpool.
Oh,
I mean,
really?
If it was me,
maybe he did.
Oh, by the way, I didn't get to say my name properly. My name is Hinderpool Sandu. Yeah. These guys will tag me in the thing. Please check
tag
out
yourself
my music.
Now.
How can I do that?
To say your socials.
Oh, my friend, please do it.
All right, don't worry.
We'll ask him in the pool.
Have you got a new tattoo, by the way?
Yeah, yes, still.
What's that on the side of your head?
Get to that, you know what I mean?
Oh, right.
INDERPAULSANDHU. Please check my music out and check my clothes out too.
Indeed. Yes, Chad Martin, we are back. We're going to keep coming back, even if it clocks out. So, yes, please do not disappear. We're going all the way to the end of this album. All
right. So, up next,
But hold up. What do you guys, before we jump, what did you guys think of the chorus?
Damn, this is a long-ass album.
Yes,
Shit.
It is.
How many songs?
There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 more songs left.
Oh, yes.
On top of the... Wow.
This is a 13-song album. Bloody
bro,
hell.
Bro, that's not a long album.
I mean,
they had a lot to say, man.
For them days, That was
no.
a lot.
No, no. When did not this come out? Bro, are you joking?
Wait, oh, when gosh. Did this come out?
This came out in, I think it came out in 90, this specific, this album, I think it came out in 92.
Oh, when albums were albums.
Yeah, when people were into albums.
Yeah, 92.
92.
Yeah, so it's 20, 31 years old.
Boy. But would you guys think of that Rain When I Die? Like, you know, that it's morbid.
I'm not gonna lie, that you know,
I think it's gonna rain when I die. That is,
I took it in a different way, innit? Like, I took it on a spiritual note, like obviously the saints.
Heather says it's a good, great song to break up the, I guess the flow of the album. Mm. No, the heaviness of the first two tracks, which is interesting. I feel like it was still pretty heavy, to be honest.
Oh, but yeah, it's quite, you know, still quite, it's still got their heaviness, but that chorus, man. It's the
rain when I die thing.
Yeah,
I took that as a different way though. Like we will rain with, you know, obviously like from a spiritual angle.
Oh,
we'll rain with God in it on the day of judgment. You know what I mean?
Wow.
The saints of God will be with God. You get me?
But
that's how I saw it.
I hear you.
That's
I hear you. I didn't.
Gonna
rain when I.
That's how
actually,
I took it.
Here it is. I think we're gonna rain when I.
Because when I heard it first, I was like, "What's he saying, man? What you mean?" It's gonna put like water drops. No. Surely it's not that surface level. Surely.
Oh yeah, you know he had a drug kind of issue.
Oh, so he did, didn't he?
Yes, he did. So there's a lot of references to his struggle in that album. Yeah, man.
Are these people still alive? They still about?
Not the lead singer, unfortunately.
Rest in peace.
Yes, the addiction got him.
Damn. And, what was his addiction?
Oh my days, guys! Can anybody tell me? Anybody tell me what his addiction? What was?
I'm guessing drugs.
Like drugs, yeah, I mean, drugs. But what type of drugs? I don't know.
Right.
Well, who knows that? You know.
I say heroin.
Could be heroin. Probably. Yeah. Probably a lot of things, man. Probably all of it. Mm. But that's a nice segue into the next song.
I said probably all of it. Anyway,
down in a hole.
Down in a hole. We ain't even got 50. To my Alice in Chains tune. If anybody knows my Alice in Chains tune, if they can guess, please put it in there. Put it in the comments. Oh, Christopher said heroin.
Okay, heroin. Yeah, right. Heroin. Is it still lagging, guys? Let us know if it's still lagging. Say yes or no.
Like, yo, I promise, Lord, if you get me out of this, I'll never drink again. I'll never smoke again. This is really, really going through.
We'll be right back.
really like that. That's nice.
Oh, what? The,
when he added just now, really nice.
Oh?
This. That's really cool. That's really nice.
What's that?
It's a bit corny though, I can't lie.
What part's corny?
The chorus. Yeah,
right, you don't like it?
What, the melody?
Just a little piece though.
Oh, really? Piece.
Well, maybe because the content matter is a bit deep as well. Once I'm down the hole.
I know.
Yeah. It's so small.
I know. Yeah. they ain't exactly the most happiest bunch.
Yeah, you ain't trying to walk down the aisle to this.
I'm telling you.
No, down in the hole. Because that shows his desperation to come out of the hole.
What?
I want to fly. I'm lying to fly.
Right.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Watch the unplugged version, says Jordan. Christopher Jordan, this, knowing that it's about what it's about, it's heart-wrenching.
Right. Do you know what was interesting? I read one of the comments. Heather said that he was dead over a week before they found him, which kind of reveals quite a lot, you know. It reveals that you don't have any friends or family. If I was dead for a week, I reckon, if I died right now, I reckon it would take approximately like 2 hours before someone starts looking for me, like
it'd be your girl.
Francine will first be like, okay, do you know what? She'll call. Do you know what? I'll tell you what will happen. She'll call me.
Uh-huh.
She'll be like, oh, he's ignoring me. He's ignoring me. So that could go on for 2 days. She'll probably be like, oh, he's ignoring me for 2 days.
Mm.
Mom and dad won't check for me. Okay. They won't check for me because I've been halfway around the world and they didn't know. And I got back and they'll be like, raw. They won't even know.
I thought you was in your room.
The whole time?
I think I could be gone for like 6 months, my parents won't ask anything.
Oh, for real?
6 months. But my girl would be like, after 3 days, she'll be like, okay, I'm going to call his parents. And then it will begin.
Right.
You know, prompt them kind of thing.
Prompt them. Mm-hmm. But what do you think? How long could you guys go before someone comes looking for you?
Knowing me, but
you, bro, I'll be belling you. Do you know why your peak? Do you know why his peak? Yeah, he'll be, because I'll be like, Charles, because you air people's messages anyway and calls. So it'll be like, yo, Charles is just blacking out.
But that's just Charles. Yeah.
After maybe like after like a week, then I'll be like messaging. Then I'll call David.
Mm-hmm.
I'll call Interpol. So if Interpol ain't spoken to you, then I'll be like, all right, let me go round week two.
Oh, real round week two.
Because I could be like, oh, this guy could be. No. It couldn't go a week. It couldn't pass a week. So I'd be like, if you miss our MSTAT session, then I'll be like,
then you know it's an issue.
And dead. No text, no nothing.
Yeah, he's dead.
I'll just show up at your yard, man. That's what I've had to do in the past to get
to
find out if he's breathing still. Just come to your yard. And he opens the door. Yo, bro. Yo. He's doing his stuff. You know what I mean?
How long do you think it will take you?
For me?
For anyone to come and look for Interpol?
I think about like, did you say, yours, you said your girl was like 2 hours, right?
2 hours, the search will begin.
Okay, from when? Okay, I think for me, maybe like, yeah, probably like 16 hours from early morning. If I haven't landed back and nobody's seen for me, like at least till 2 a.m, then.
Who's
then,
the first person though?
This is gonna, so really. Me March. 3 weeks.
Three no. weeks? No, if two. I wasn't around.
I think I agree with JB's assessment still.
Yeah,
because he would just be like, oh, this guy, man.
Yeah.
Well, and especially if you call him and you hear his Charles, the voice note,
the voicemail.
But yeah, this man's he's tired. Yeah. He's lost his phone.
Yeah,
messed up his phone.
It's crazy.
Some
guys, I know this is a stupid question, but how long? Put how many weeks or days it will take for people to come and look for you? I know it's so such a morbid, but you can't. It's such a morbid question, but it's like I'm actually interested. It's a very revealing question as well. It lets you know if you're kind of, if you are a personable person or not. But to be left in your apartment for a week and no one knew you were dead is wild.
But it's interesting though, yeah, because you're very personable
right.
person.
Right.
It's just you're like, you're just elusive, man. You're like that brother that, you know, you see across on the platform and the train comes, he disappears, he's right beside you. You're that guy.
Yeah, you are. Yeah. Mm-hmm. What are people saying?
Let me see. Yeah, he was melted.
He was melted
to the floor.
Wow. Melted to the floor.
Wow.
How was he melted to the floor?
No teeth left.
What? He wanted to do drugs and not be bothered by anyone. He had the money to do so, and so he did.
Mm.
What?
Yeah, these guys don't realize how sad the story of Lane's addiction really is. Maybe Charles does. Oh, yes, I do.
What?
No. We're not making our jokes about
it. No. He's not saying that. He's not saying that though. Several of the songs on this record are a cry for help, in my view.
I think it's important to understand the context of the album as well. So that's why it's I like doing these deep dives, because we get people interacting, giving us the nitty gritty, the information that we always overlook when we look in the comments. People want to give you the whole biography, we're not looking for that. But now when you listen to the album, it makes sense. And now let's go in. We're not even like halfway through. Go into the rest of the songs. It might open up my eyes a little bit to kind of think, oh, what is this song about? Or why were these artistic choices chosen?
Mm. Scott Mukumba says about a week for him.
A week, okay. Him too. Mm-hmm. Oh,
somebody said Phil said 3 days. Mama will come if I don't pick up the kid.
Oh,
said, Phil. That's a good one though, still, man. You know, you got a routine there, gotta keep the routine going.
Yeah, wow.
It says my BF wouldn't go more than a few hours.
Oh, that's love.
A few hours. Yeah, that is real love. That's real love.
Come on.
Busting through the house.
Shout out to Mal and her man, you know what I mean?
Wow.
Mm. Okay, wait till you hear Junkhead. Okay.
Junkhead.
Yeah. I'll sit you next to one. All right, sir.
That's my top song. Nobody's guessed my top song on this album. Nobody's gotten there. Nobody said it. Come on, right, guys.
Let's hit the next song.
You have a top song on this?
Oh yeah. There's a Sick tune. Man. I love on this.
This song is called Sick Man. This song is called Sick Man.
My Sick Man.
Let's go.
Don't care who you are. Okay, sorry. I'll tell you, it's grounding.
Christopher Jordan, you're right.
What does Christopher Jordan
say? He got my song.
Okay.
Yeah, he got my song.
Is it still lagging, guys? Let me know. I'm paranoid now.
Brandon said, you guys gotta know that this music was a scene back in the day.
Pardon?
Yeah, Brandon said, you guys gotta know that this music was a scene back in the day.
Really?
Yeah, so it's like a whole vibe, a whole thing, the culture in itself.
Right.
Phil said it's lagging, but it's all good.
Oh, bloody hell.
But I feel like what they've shared about his addiction really does give a, an understanding to the sound. Because this really does sound like it's a bit, you can just imagine him being waved.
Yeah.
And then he's recording bits, maybe on different days, and then he's just, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Sounds a bit System of a Down here.
Oh, really?
Interesting.
I hear you.
Like the highest pitch of the melody. Oh, even...
Is it Uzi Vert who did a System of a Down cover recently?
Uzi Vert?
Yeah.
The don that put the thing in his head?
I think that's it.
Sick man.
I think so.
Yeah, Bernie.
Young Charles on the guitar, yeah? What's the drum saying to you, bro?
It's alright.
He's not feeling
that
it.
That seems like a reserve.
He's not feeling it. Context of the music, bro. Context of the music. It doesn't need to be chopping or nothing.
No, I'm not saying it has to be. Mm. I don't want it to be. It's just arresting. Yes, it's doing its job.
You know the funny thing is about this tune?
Yeah.
Go on.
This is the kind of tune that I would see you kind of making, bro.
Me?
Yeah.
Because of the bare transition,
the
right?
Yes.
Yeah, the madness to it. Yeah,
yes,
I hear
indeed.
It still.
Yeah.
I hear it still. That's why I like it. That's why you're sucking my dick. More information about the scene. It was a really drug-heavy scene.
Oh, really?
Scott McComber was saying, I was so young at the time that came out that all my memories of the music are super happy, even with a depressed subject matter. I think that's like one of the great things about listening to music when you're young. Don't fully understand the context.
Yeah,
you just appreciate it for what it, you know.
Right. It's true.
It kind of sad though when you grow up, because then you're like, damn, that's what he was singing about.
That's what they was talking about.
That's what he was going through.
Bruh.
Yeah.
What do you think of
that's
that
sick
tune?
Man. I think it was artistically. It sounded like a sick man. Mm. You know, you could even just with the basics of like the motive changes throughout the whole song. We're here, then we're here. They added some. A little effects here and there that they don't normally use, or they haven't used in the rest of the songs, like little different little trinkets, little ear candy in places. Mm. It was cool. I mean, it was, now that I get the context of it, and I know that he was just really strung out on drugs in a way. Mm. It just brings context to the whole situation. So,
hear that.
It sounds like a song now. If I ever did have a drug problem, I'd probably want to slap on, because in a weird way it's kind of like the soundtrack to someone who is in a bad way. Mm, you know. And it's kind of like, I know it sounds a little bit toxic, but it's like, yeah, in my head it's like I've put this in a little box where it's like, yo, if I'm ever going through some real, you know,
well, you come back to these
oh
tunes.
Yeah, you'll just be like, what album can I listen to that's going to allow me to feel yeah,
wallow.
Soak and wallow in the mess,
right?
You know, it. And here's the thing, is it going to be helpful?
Mm.
Is it a helpful album? Is it something that I would, that's where it gets a bit tricky, because I don't know if it would help or if it would perpetuate my going in deeper into that hole. Do you get what I'm saying? So it's a tough one because music does affect your mood.
It does. And look, 100%, I will say that, like, the grunge scene had its issues. It wasn't that, like, oh, the grunge scene was now reaching out to be doing drugs or everything like that. That was just kind of like the darker side of things. It just always ended up being an after effect, or was it the start?
I feel like the drugs started it. So here's the question.
The love of music.
Start is the love of music. If he didn't do drugs, does his album sound like this?
Did he sound like this when he first entered the market?
Exactly.
I think creatively, yes, he came with this, but then, like, we're talking the influence of melody and the lyrical content. Yes, I think that was led by the drug addiction, but the creativity, definitely not. The creativity was like they want a band, they want artists based off of drugs. You know what I'm saying? That was not the core. Wasn't what ignited it. What ignited it was the love of music, to be with your brethrens making music, making great rock music, bro.
I got a curveball for that, though. So let's say that they entered in the, like you said, it's creativity, right? You had that.
Like anybody that started off in the rock scene, they just wanted to hear, like anybody that even wanted to listen to great stuff. You heard great tunes, like, you know, rock-centered tunes that was different and was not the whole hair metal stuff, arena rock, like you said, that was just coming from a different angle, that felt more personal. Yes, they had deeper issues.
Yeah.
It would just seem to be more deeper. Right. They had more substance than the music, that the party tunes that were out there before and stuff like that. So it's you know.
Can't it be a thing, though, like, he came into the game and then, I don't know, he's done his trick to get all the attention of people. And then maybe he's finding what he was once doing before wasn't working, and where the drugs was now used for. Because anybody that's had any kind of addiction will tell you that it starts off as fun, right? That you're enjoying it. Mm. And then now somehow, some way, you need this to function. You need this to, you know, to go through your normal day. Mm. So it's almost like I can imagine, you know, like he might have got the attention of the people there, and then afterwards he was like, oh man, it's not working.
Mm.
Or, you know, I need something. And then the edge just got further and further and further away.
When you say it's not working, what's not working?
So, like, okay, cool. So, like, I don't know the trajectory of this band. It's a band, isn't it?
Yeah.
Cool. I don't know the trajectory of them, but let's just say, like, they put out an album and they got all the punters listening, all the, you know, people was really getting into them.
Okay.
And then their follow-up album after that didn't do too well. Or...
Okay.
But in that initial stage, right, he's getting waved, you know, he's doing his thing.
Waved means getting high, drunk.
Check it. Hear the rest of the trajectory.
Okay. I'm gonna give you time. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna give you time. Go on.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Cool. So that this is all hypothetical at this point, right? Mm. So people in the comments, if this is true, please. If it's not, you know, whatever, say the same.
Mm.
He puts out an album. They put out that album.
Right.
It's great. It does bits. It does numbers.
Mm-hmm.
Then their follow up doesn't really take the way it did take before, right?
Right.
Cool. But people are still messing with him, right?
Okay.
In the Come Up, which was the first album, let's say,
mm-hmm.
it was getting waved, getting high, getting drunk, enjoying themselves. Everything was cool, right?
Right.
The second project doesn't do so well. So they're still doing the drugs.
This is a hypothetical.
Go. They're still doing the drugs. But now the drugs ain't associated with happy times.
Okay.
It's associated with, like, oh man, we got to make a project that the people are going to like and rah, rah, rah.
Okay.
Then out of desperation, they come up with some next alternative thing.
Okay.
In a studio where they was in a funny kind of mind and place and so on.
Right.
And yeah, that's like a vicious cycle you've now built yourself into. From being getting high, having fun, to not having fun but still needing to get high, creating.
Mm-hmm.
And then, oh wow, the people actually like it when I'm miserable. Okay, cool. Maybe it's like method acting. You know, there's people that have method acting.
You know what?
They get stuck in it. Okay. You know what I mean?
I get, you know what?
So say sorry then if you get what I'm saying. Say sorry.
I'm
just saying the story was going a bit funky, man.
No, because you kept doing this. Your facial expressions were throwing me off. You was messing me around. Okay.
All right. Okay. Okay. I get what you're saying. I get what you're saying.
You know what? I could just summarized it in. You know what? It's like method acting. Right. Some people get caught up in the juice.
Yes, I would agree. I feel like some. I agree with your point actually. Mm. A lot.
Touch me.
I think Charles is in. You've got to take Charles with a pinch of salt because I feel like you're in love with the genre so much.
I think you're a bit blinded. I'm trying to understand
the argument. It's done. What are people saying though? I'm seeing loads of paragraphs over there. What are people saying?
All right, in the pool, go on.
Same, do we say a Scott Swan? Yeah. Mal said she agreed with Scott about the, you know, when you're younger and you're listening to music, you don't know about the true meaning.
Right.
Brandon Boucher, hope I said your name right. Very in the moment kind of vibe. If pop was the cutting edge, this was the anti-counter culture cutting edge, bit like what you were saying. I feel like it's a you had to be there type of movement.
Right.
Like how I imagined the Doors was.
Okay. The Doors? What's the Doors?
The Doors, the band.
Oh, never heard the Doors.
Oh, wow. Okay. I hear that. Yeah, go on.
Christopher Jordan, you want
to? Oh, yes. Christopher Jordan says, it helps sometimes. It harms sometimes. Oh, okay. We're talking. I guess
he's talking about the drugs
and all that. Look,
damn.
The Christopher Jordan says also the environment creates the artist. The artist turns.
That is what I'm talking about, Christopher. Come on, that's what I was saying, bro. But you know, this thing that he was having fun with now, the thing that he was enjoying, has now become a crutch.
Very interesting. Okay. We're on to Junkyard, the song that I think who said we'll be excited about this song, Junkyard or something. I think
that was
that Heather. Did Heather say that?
I'm gonna scroll up. He was melted to the floor. That was deep.
I can't remember who said that, but we're about to get into Junkyard.
Let's hit it.
So without further ado, or have I missed the song? Have we done Rooster?
No, we haven't.
Okay, it's Rooster time. Oh, I like that. Yeah. I like this. If we loop this, I'll sample this.
Really?
Yeah. This is hot. Don't let me down. Cha-cha. Is that out of key?
Hear that out of key?
That is out of tune. That is off.
I think one of the layers is. I don't think all of it.
That is off. That is off. The harmony. They found a way to kill me yet. What? Is it only my ears?
I didn't hear it.
Shoot, this is off.
What, him now?
The vocal.
Heather says that there's those harmonies. Out of tune on purpose. Says Christopher Jordan.
So you didn't know it was out of tune? You couldn't hear that?
And you know what? I've heard this song so many times. Like from when I was like a teenager onwards, maybe I'm just used to it. That's not a tune.
That's what he was doing.
He was not.
That's not in that key. That's.
That's not what he was doing, bro.
That note is not. That's no. That's not what he was doing.
Bro, I know this tune, bro. That's
what he was doing, bro. You know what? As much as this man battled with addiction, you can tell he has some. There's a fight to his spirit.
Oh, the song is called Junkheads, not Junkyard. That's my dyslexia.
Oh.
JB Remix.
Yeah.
Gullet or something.
Yeah, rooster. We need to find out what rooster means. That's what.
Anybody got any ideas about a rooster?
Yeah, does anyone know what rooster means? Yeah.
I have an idea. I have an idea of what the rooster is, but I won't say anything yet.
Okay.
The rooster sounds quite powerful.
I can just imagine being super drunk and stumbling, just like
what on this gym?
Or proper stoned and just sitting in the settee, just like
just stuck there, like,
just stuck, like melting into the
sofa.
Have you ever been that like inebriated that you're just, you feel like you're literally sinking into the?
Yes. Yes. Even now, unfortunately, because I'm so lightweight, I could take one drink and I'd be like...
It's true. It's actually true. That was me on your birthday, still. In the backseat, just...
Oh, gosh. Here they come to snuff the rooster.
You know what though, I'm not gonna lie, I'm a fan of these men still.
Huh?
I'm a fan of these men still.
Oh, like, really?
Yeah, yeah, man, I like it.
Oh, for real?
Mm-hmm.
Hey. Really? You know we ain't gonna die.
Oh, so Mal P said that this is a song about Jerry's dad's experience in the Vietnam War.
Who's Jerry?
Oh. I assume that's
Jerry,
the band.
Guitarist.
Oh.
Mm, you remember I said there's kind of
right.
Like two.
Right.
Lane Staley, Jerry Cantrell.
Right.
Lane Stanley's fingerprint is this vocal style, said by Brandon Boucher. Pen Dizzy said the rooster is poop. Oh, the rooster is about heroin.
Oh, is it?
That's what Pen Dizzy's saying.
Oh, rooster is poop. Who said rooster is poop?
Pen Dizzy as well.
Oh, rooster is poop.
So were these men on, was it heroin that Steely Dan? Is it heroin that he passed on?
Yeah, that's what they're saying.
Oh, hold up. Wait, rooster was his dad's call sign in Nam.
What okay, do you mean? You know,
this is conflicting now. Someone's saying it's heroin.
We're getting two different, you know, guys. What's going on?
The only way that's going to work, Pen Dizzy and Ingo, you must fight. You must fight.
Deal to the death.
Deal to the death. And the winner is the winner of the truth. But you know what? Either one makes sense because Ingo said Rooster was his dad's call sign in the army. So maybe that was like his like nickname in the army. Oh, Rooster's got him. Ah, Rooster, come on,
right.
You know,
okay.
Kind of thing.
Okay.
Mm. You guys ever had a chance to visit SoCal? What's that?
SoCal.
I know this thing. I know SoCal.
What's SoCal?
I know it, but...
Is it a music thing?
I think it's a place.
Oh, okay.
It's definitely about Vietnam.
Oh, really?
Big up yourself, Phil.
Okay. But what do you feel about the song?
I want feeling this song, but it feels like a... wait a minute. It actually does feel like heroin.
Oh, really? What, the song?
Yeah.
Wow.
Not that I've tried heroin, but it did feel very like and those guys, I don't know if that's what the effect that heroin has on people. I don't know if it makes them hurt or if it makes them, you know.
No, heroin is definitely a downer.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's a downer.
Okay, then.
So they would feel that way. You were saying that. Oh,
I can see it. I can definitely see it. Part of me, it's gonna sound really stupid and like I'm trying to be funny, but no, I'm not. Like, I feel like listening to this album, to do it true justice, you would need to have a drink or something to actually encapsulate and really, you know, it's like watching a 3D movie without the glasses.
This is
what I feel like we're doing right now. We are literally listening to this or watching this without the 3D glasses. If we had the 3D glasses on, we would be able to see the things coming out on the screen that the director intended for us to, you know, when they do the, and you're like, oh, okay, that's what you, you know. So again, I think that's why I keep saying, if I ever do get to a place where it's like too much, you know, I will slap on this album. Or the next time I'm a little bit drunk, I might listen to this album and just see if it, you know, I might have a spiritually awakening, like, yo, this is dope.
See, now there's a part of me wishing that it was not revealed that, you know, heroin and whatever else was attached to the lyrics of this album, because maybe our minds would have been free to just interpret it the way that we wanted
that.
To.
I hear that as well. You know what I mean? Yeah,
but,
I do.
Okay, but then that's like watching a movie with no sound on.
Right.
It totally changes the picture. It totally, like, imagine watching Bad Boys or like any movie without no sound and just looking at the movie, or watch Avatar without sound.
That would be wild.
Watch Avatar without sound.
That would be wild.
I hear you.
It totally changes. It changes it completely. That's why I think context is important.
I would curve that though, man.
Because where this one is sound, with when you watch the satin visual, you have satin on screen.
Right.
So like your imagination and that for that part is kind of dormant, let's say. But then when you're listening to satin and then you just have to imagine a thing, your imagination can like paint some wicked pictures, man.
Right.
Wicked pictures.
I think with first reactions though, when listening to a song for the first time, I think we just listen to the music. We're listening to like the instrumentation, like the drums. Like I wasn't even thinking about the individual instruments. I was listening to the music as a whole. Now that I've got some more context, whereas when I didn't have context, I was just like, oh, I like that cymbal, I like the tom sound. It totally changes the way you're talking about the music. So this is actually showing me that context is important. Maybe we should do some research on the artist before we listen to the song for future reactions. Nothing too deep.
People would agree with that on our channel.
Yeah. Nothing too deep, but just a little Wikipedia type thing. Okay, this is where it comes from. All right, cool, let's get in.
Okay.
I think you should study the effects of guitarists and heroin and use Charles as the guinea pig.
Our next video will be, we can't even say that word, or this video will just get squam. We got to say fellowin.
Oh, fellowin. Oh, yes. Terrorin.
Terrorin. Wow. And Lewabide instead of
Lewabide.
I never.
What's the people saying?
Okay, you go first because you're quite quick.
SoCal. So SoCal is Southern California. Thank you very much, Brandon.
No, I haven't been to Southern California.
We're gonna come there one time. Phil Shertok, walking tall machine gun men. They spit on me in what? Oh, okay, I think these are the lyrics. They spit on me in my homeland. Gloria sent me pictures of my boy. Got my pills against mosquito death. My buddy's breathing is dying. Breath, oh God, please, won't you help? Okay, that definitely sounds like a scene out of Vietnam.
That's sad, man. Sad.
Wow.
20th Century Refugee. Alice in Chains is a very thick and swampy type of rock. Thick and swampy, I think that's a good...
That is beautiful. Wow,
that is a really good description.
Beautiful description. Swampy, I like that.
Up and Dizzy recounted the rooster being about heroin. My bad, you are all right. Haha, it's all love, Pendizzy. 20th Century Refugee, dark and broody feel to AIC. Definitely. Pendizzy, I read the story, sad AF. I had to come back and admit I was wrong. Christopher Jordan, just look at the album cover. Someone struggling underneath, something they can't escape. Have we got a picture of the album cover?
I know the album cover though, but
we do.
Do we?
No, we don't. I don't have it on tap. But okay, I have seen the album cover before. It used to scare me. Like,
what's it look like?
It's just like imagine seeing a guy being buried under sand, or like the floor, like trying to come out of the floor. But that's kind of what it feels like to be.
When you're waved.
Waved. No, I mean.
When you're high or addiction.
A guy or girl?
Yeah, it's very.
It's a weight.
Yeah, it's a weight. It's very. This is a very artistic album. Now that the more context you get, the more you turn the volume up on the sound, you start to understand the story and you appreciate it a lot differently. You know?
Does that mean you're having a different look on Alice in Chains now?
From an artistic, there's so many categories in my brain. From an artistic standpoint, yeah, like, you know, I always say to you, there's programs that you can watch on rerun, and then there's programs that you can only watch once. Like certain movies you could only watch once. This is like a one listen type thing, you know, so I wouldn't be playing it constantly in my ears, but
I appreciate it.
Yeah, I saw something
move too.
Anyway, I'm gonna check that out.
Is there somebody behind it?
knows?
Is there somebody behind the reveal yourself?
No.
Okay.
Oh, something dropped.
I thought.
It's gonna be spooky in here now.
Alright, what's the next song?
Alright, hold up. Brendan Boucher says, I don't know if it's appropriate on this stream, but there's an up and coming artist here in Los Angeles that's making waves named Lewis Cole.
We hate Los Angeles.
I would love to hear you guys check him out. Okay.
No, I'm joking. We don't hate. Do you know what, bro?
Lewis Cole.
Put that down. Write that down.
Right.
We will get to that on Monday. We're meeting on Monday, not on Sunday.
All right.
Monday.
All right. Cool.
Yeah.
Write that down. All right. Lewis Cole.
All right. So we are actually on. Was that what song was that? Was that Junkhead?
That was Rooster.
Okay. Now we're on Junkhead.
All right. Let's go. Now this one I remember had this one I could honestly say, oh yeah, this one's about drugs. Because I remember the lyrics of this tune.
Yeah. I mean, he's gonna be deaf to not know that it's about drugs. Yeah, yeah. I feel like he's in a different stage of his addiction, though, with these kind of lyrics.
He likes that note. Aww. He loves that note, don't he?
It's so interesting, right? Not to touch on the comments ahead of time, but what they're talking about heroin. I was just talking to someone the other day about heroin had its own cool phase. You know, where it was cool in quotes.
Right. Through popular culture. Cool to do heroin, yeah.
To do heroin. I have to think that's insane, man.
Yeah.
You know, just inject something in your...
That's crazy.
You know, mental. Inject. Oh, Pen Dizzy. No, we got to big this guy up, though. He said he's been clean sober 13 years from other stuff. Pen Dizzy.
Well done, brother.
That wasn't easy, but you did it, man.
Maybe you shouldn't be listening to this stream.
He says thank you. Well done, Pen Dizzy.
Oh, she's a girl. Well done, ma'am.
Oh,
well
she's
done.
A girl.
Well
oh,
done,
oh, oh, oh. She said.
Come on. Look, everyone's clapping in the comments. We got yourselves. Very nice bunch you got here.
Oh, don't bend it.
I like this.
You can't.
he's making a very deep statement over this. What is your drug of choice? Because I clocked, he said a bar about, or a lyric about hypocrite. And I have heard, like, this thing about addiction you're spoken of, like, you know what, your addiction is that, but my addiction is this.
Mm.
You know what I mean? You might be a junkie for that, I'm a junkie for this. There's a lot of, like, false hierarchy in the way that we look at one another, but this guy's ruining himself just with something else. Working himself to death.
Yeah.
I'm smoking myself to death, kind of thing. Yeah. But yeah. Yeah.
That's interesting.
I hear what you're saying. Nice ending. Kind of like that ending.
Abrupt, didn't it?
Yeah.
Oh.
My type of ending. Bum, bum. I like that.
Yeah, it's getting a bit slow now.
Oh, it's getting slow.
Yeah, it's getting a bit slow. It's getting a bit. It's getting a bit like, oh, we're doing this again.
I hear you.
I mean, I would have taken out the third song.
Mm.
Definitely taken out the third song.
Okay.
Let the fourth one play because that one slowed things down.
Right.
I would have condensed this album to like a 9-track album, and it would have been more potent. I think.
I mean, it was very. It was quite potent. It kicked them into the stratosphere.
No, I hear it. No, not in terms of like, oh yeah,
of potent course, for you.
Potent for me in right, terms of like you. Pacing of the album. I mean, if this is your bag, yeah, 100%. But it just feels a little bit, samey. You know, it's like, we've got 9 drug songs.
Mm.
Okay.
I mean, the whole album.
Yeah. It's the whole album. But you know what? As I said before, like, it's a movie, so you can't really take scenes out of it. It don't make sense without it. So. I'm enjoying it, but I'm like, every movie has that bit where they're just talking. It's like, okay, pick up again.
Next scene.
Yeah, yeah. Next scene. So that was that for me. That was a bit of a next scene. All right, what's next? All right, cool.
Mm.
I think I'm with JB on that. I don't know about. I like the narrative of the song about like calling out the double standard in people. Mm. I think that's a new element that we haven't seen. Mm. But the musical aspect to it, yeah, man, it just
musically sounds.
Yeah, musically, very, like, bro.
Yeah,
you know, keep the song but change the music. Yeah. Man. Yeah.
You, but you know what I'm saying, like it's the tone is like they couldn't really crazily change the tone for what it, I mean, yeah, how can I say I guess the style, the tone of the band itself, that's their style, that's their tone, like, yeah. You know, it's that's their sound, right. If they now throwing dynamics and different types of, it wouldn't be an Alice in Chains album, if you get what I mean. I don't know how I can explain.
I hear you.
That's what kind of made them unique amongst other bands.
The palette that they're using. Yeah, right. Okay. Cool.
You know,
I hear it.
But yeah.
All right. Let's move. What's the people saying quickly? Let's see if you know. What are the people? Oh, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. We've got 5 songs left.
Someone added you at Indipal Sam dude.
No, that was Brandon Boucher that was saying, where do I find the music? Brandon, you can just, if you click on my name, or if you just type in my, or if you just copy and paste my name into Google, Instagram, but I'm on every single e-store, man. Every single e-store.
Nice.
20th Century Refugee is tapping into the narrative I was speaking about. So we're all addicted to escape. Whether by music, films, games, food, or drugs. Drugs are just a vessel of the escape. And you know what? Yeah, it's true. Especially in this current climate, I think everyone's a crackhead for happiness. Yeah. Everyone is just happiness crackheads. No one's on this stuff, like stoic stuff, or like, you know, all right, cool. Maybe I'm not going to have to be able to smile properly for the next 6 months, but I'll be able to smile properly for 3 years after that.
Yeah.
You know, everyone's on this crackhead and happiness stuff. And, you know, and I don't mean to use that word in an inflammatory way. I'm just saying, like, you know, you just made this thing your be all and end all, just being happy living for the moment.
Yeah.
And that's a quick crash.
Quick bump.
Mm. Oh, somebody's going. Pen Dizzy is leaving.
Pen Dizzy.
Pen Dizzy, all right.
See you later, ma'am. Rest well.
Woman.
I said ma'am.
Oh, ma'am.
What the hell's wrong with
ma'am.
You?
Ma'am. Sorry. You rest don't well, ma'am.
You should brush your teeth.
That's
what I had to say. You're like, nah, Paul, you came a bit quick with that.
I'm a leave you have that. You came quick.
I hear it still. So, Gyal said, no, I'm joking. My bad. I'm breaking everything. Sorry. That's not a good thing. In the pool, yeah, I ruined it by being clumsy. You happy?
That's even now.
Yeah.
You guys are even.
This is a great thing you guys are doing. I appreciate the channel.
Hey. That means a lot. That means a lot.
Yeah, that does, you know. Cool. Hey, look, we'll keep doing it as well. We'll keep doing it. You know, just make sure you guys keep tuning in because, you know, even when things go wrong, you know what I mean? Hey, but still.
Yeah. Mm. Godsmacked. Godsmacked?
Godsmacked is the name.
Is that where Godsmack actually, the band, got their name from?
That's an interesting title.
I know, that is a smacked, bit of a mad title.
Smacked by God.
Yeah.
Smacked
yeah.
by God, that's what he means.
Is it smacked by God?
No, God smacked.
Is it a play on the English gobsmacked?
Yeah, probably is. Probably a bit of both. Probably, you know.
I bet it's going to sound dreary. Interesting.
This is going to sound, I think this is going to be a mischievous song. Jeez.
Another song about heroin.
Is it another song about heroin?
I appreciate it, Brandon. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm out.
But nah, you can't be out. We're going all the way, bro. I know this guy. I knew he was out before we even started.
I'm struggling.
I know you are, bro.
Turn up a bit.
But I can't lie, this is a lot different. Sense God smacked, God smacked.
Like I'm guessing this is the best heroin, like this is the heroin of the gods kind of thing.
Oh, okay.
Maybe. Christopher Jordan, that was a good call out earlier. That AIC occasionally has System of a Down vibe.
The vocal is irritating with withdrawal from heroin, by the way.
Oh, this song is about withdrawing from heroin.
Oh, the vocal is... Oh, imitating. I thought it says irritating. Oh, it is. I thought
typo just changed the whole sentence quick. Mm-hmm.
It's withdrawing from heroin. I don't get it.
So you're saying the vocal's imitating withdrawal from heroin.
Oh, okay.
And Phil went on to say, God's name is smack for some.
Is a line in the song.
Charles is unhappy.
I don't know the context there, so I'm going to leave that alone.
Phil, so could you elaborate on that though? So that's in like the God's name. Somebody would say like, I don't know, Jehovah instead of smack.
Because if it is, we're shutting this down.
Yeah, like right here, right now. I do like that. I like that. It adds like really chaotic kind of vibe.
Mm.
Yeah.
Oh, I heard the lyric. I heard what he just said.
What did he say?
God's name is smack for some. I just heard him say it in the lyrics.
Oh, is it like God's name is crack for like drugs for some people? like God, God's name is drugs for
is
people.
Smack for yeah, like drugs for like, some people.
Talking
yeah.
about like Christians are like too high on Jesus or something.
Wow. Does anybody know if this guy had any like you know
religious
religious kind of background? Because maybe he in his like withdrawal and when he's on his way out trying whatever, he had that experience, you know, like that guy from Korn.
Mm.
You know,
which one? The bassist.
Yeah, with the dreads and the, or maybe they all have dreads. You know, but the with the eyeliner. Mm. He became a Christian, but he was talking about like, yo, I was heavy on the drugs, and then I never had a high like Jesus.
I think I think that was Head, the guitarist.
Yeah. Okay. Mm. Okay. Yeah.
What are people saying? I want to get answers. Give me some answers.
Oh, they said what's that? Yes. Oh, okay. Somebody's coming. Is that for the authentic experience of listening to this in the 90s? You guys should have the CD jacket and be reading it as you experience this. This show, we did it in our day.
Oh, like you know when you buy the thing.
Do you know what? Mm. When we get a little bit more cash, when we get a bit more cash, what we'll do is we'll buy the CD and we'll plop it into the CD player and we'll look at the sleeve and we'll do it properly. That's a good,
I think that's a really
good
idea.
If we're going to really do it, let's do it. Let's not do the Spotify thing. Let's do it how it was meant to be done.
Brandon said, if you guys do Louis Co on Monday, do the quality over opinion album. Got to dip out, but I'll catch you Monday. All the best, Brandon.
All right, Brandon.
What time is it Brandon. In America right now, I wonder?
It's like...
they're 7 hours ahead of us, I think.
A.M.?
Yeah, it's like A.M. or something like
really?
That. Really?
Yeah. No, ain't it like midnight over there?
Is it? For real? I don't know. I guess they're going to tell us.
Have you put the heating on? Because you cold?
Yeah, but I'm powering through.
Are you cold?
I'm a little
I mean, his
cold.
Shirt says he's cold. So, as in his shirt literally says, I'm cold.
Yeah, I'm cold.
all right,
cool, anyway, cool.
Let's go. Next one.
This song is called Untitled.
Boy, we haven't gone to my one yet.
Oh, wow. 20th Century Refugee just dropped a bomb. So he said, God's name is Smack for some, meaning that heroin is God for addicts.
Oh.
That and the penny dropped.
Oh, heroin is...
That's true.
Heroin everything for, is for, God for addicts. Okay.
Oh, I get it. God's name... It's Smack for some. Like, okay.
That was very insightful, 20th Century Refugee.
Interesting.
I hear that.
Oh, no, you were right. It's AM.
It's AM.
AM, what? So, in the morning?
11 AM and 10:53 in Illinois. Okay. And 9 AM for Brandon Boucher.
Oh, damn.
So, they're going to work or they're shoot. Getting over the Saturday.
Oh, wow.
Let's go. Look at JB. Eyes getting red. When the eyes start getting red,
yeah, this is sounding like he's having a bad trip.
You're seeing stuff.
Red Rum Murder. A bit Iron Maiden, would you say?
Yeah, I haven't actually listened to Iron Maiden.
I will say one thing though. I would love them to read. Some albums I wish people, I wonder how they would record it nowadays.
Sonically.
Yeah, sonically. Right. And we're missing a good song.
Definitely a Charles song. Such a Charles song.
I like that. That's
definitely
falling down the stairs.
Anyone have any information about his parents and his family, upbringing and stuff? I'm talking about his dad here. Not to the, in the comments.
Oh, right.
That's those grunge solos. Grunge solos were just like slightly abstract, you know what I mean? It was less about like
dexterity.
Yeah, yeah.
More about the feel.
Yeah, just, you know. Like my old man. Oh no, we're back on. Stop for a moment.
Over the street?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Wow. Oh, this is my tune. Yeah. This is my tune. Straight in with my tune.
Oh, you want to go straight in?
Nah.
I've got one more song left.
All right, this. I didn't realize that was at the end.
I'm done, man. I'm done.
Bruv.
I'm tapped out.
Bruv, what were we saying about that? What were we saying about that tune?
I want it to end.
Really?
Yeah, man. It's fair to say that this album's about drugs, man. We get it. Drugs, heroin. This is
well, like I said, you know, I didn't know that listening to it at the time, and I just put my own interpretations on certain things, and you know, I ain't gonna lie, I still got the vibe of something quite depressing, but it was a sweet spot for me.
This song?
No, the whole album.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you know, had the sweet kind of. You know, met certain people would.
This is like when you want to feel good, you put this album.
You know, look, you know, hey, what can I say? I won't say, like I said, the grunge wasn't exactly the happiest music, but it definitely, it did make you feel that what was being sung about had some weight to it. You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Yeah. That's interesting. Mm. It didn't feel fluffy and just like pointless. It felt like there was a lot more. I can attest to that. This album does feel like, it does feel heavy. It does feel more artistic than I thought before. I don't think it has the characteristic. Well, for me, it doesn't have the replay value or characteristics of an album that you could just slap on at any time and enjoy and walking down the street and I'm bopping to this song. I've got to sit down and really, you know, take in this album. And you've got to be in a certain place to really to get it. You can't just be like, if you're mad happy and life is going well,
and you just like, slap on one of this,
it's not gonna touch you, you know. Right. Unless you have some, like, again, childhood memories to the song, like you remember your dad playing this or something like that, then yeah. So, but album wise, I'm ready for this movie to be done. Have you ever seen a good movie and you're like, man, okay, just wrap up this last quarter of the film, like just tie it up, man.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
and they're just
yeah.
dragging it out. It's yeah. like everyone's saying their goodbyes. It's like, yeah, it was nice saving the world of you, my man.
Mm-hmm. Remember when we did that?
Remember
and the thing is,
in the scene, man, at the beginning.
And that part that when Mr. Jimmy
and
Jam when he came
when
through.
And he did that as well.
Yeah. Did he do
and
that?
Then, because yeah. we did that. Oh, we all
wait a minute. There's another villain.
Oh no!
I hate that, and then it will go into another. It's like, so to me, yeah. I just want the last song to hit and just get me home.
All right,
get me home, and I'm interested to see what song they end on. Actually, what are people saying?
The comments are going crazy.
What are they saying?
Someone's bigging up the 20th century refugees, bigging up the Goku on the table.
For real. The other guy's on the floor. What's
the other
name?
Guy, Majin Buu. His name's Majin Buu, bro.
Majin Buu.
You don't know Dragon Ball Z like that?
Nah, not
my
really.
Favorite
what
character.
What the hell?
Not really.
Majin Buu's your favorite character?
Yes.
Who's your, a bit of a digression, but anybody got a favorite character from Dragon Ball Z? I don't know, man. Sometimes it's Vegeta for me, man. Sometimes, because, you know, he's like a cool villain.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He's a cool villain. You know, he's not always a bad guy.
Anti-hero.
He's a bad guy? Yes, but, you know, he has his hero-like moments, you know?
Yeah.
Whatever said, I love this album. You guys made a good choice. Shout out to the M-Stack crew here still.
Wow.
Right.
Guys, before we even get to the last song, I want you guys to think, what album do you guys want us to listen to next?
Can I put one forward?
You can put one forward.
The Miseducation of Lauryn Hill.
Anyway, Heather says, JB,
I don't even like Lauryn Hill, man.
Snobs.
Regretting this.
You're like Lauryn Hill.
Nah, man. Her head is too big, bro. She really thinks she thinks she's a genius. And someone said this the other day. I think it was Cat Williams. He said that we have put Kanye in this position that we've made him believe that he's a genius for writing lyrics to a song. Like, you're not a genius because you wrote lyrics to a song. You're not a genius.
But you can be a genius and write lyrics to a song.
Do you know what a genius is?
Right.
Do you know what a genius... Because he made Touch the Sky. I can come up with rap right now. Like, you can't throw around genius everywhere.
Okay,
Lauryn Hill is one of those people that they're like, oh, she's so... No, you came up with one good album.
Two songs. All two right. songs.
Someone,
want,
I
two
say,
songs.
Okay, someone
Adam
that
Lives
has...
in Fury and Social Drugs. Do me a favor. Listen to them two songs and tell me. Those aren't genius songs. Rhythms.
By
tunes.
Who?
Lauryn Hill.
Anyway.
I'm not on this Kanye West thing.
Right.
Just Lauryn Hill.
Right.
Yeah. Them two songs in particular, bro.
Right.
Vibes and moods.
Okay, cool.
Going to the corner store, cleaning the whatever. Listen to them.
Fine.
Yeah, I'm not gonna.
You
lie
know what? We'll go into that debate again. We'll get to into.
But
that
yeah, what album you guys want to listen to? Or want us to listen to? And we'll bring some more guests in as well and get it rolling. Bring Interpol back if you want him back, guys.
If you want me back, if you don't, it's alright. You'll never see my face again. Scott McCumber, a lot of people have said some stuff, Charlie boy.
All right. Scott McCumber has said, little known fact about Layne Staley is he started out as a drummer, actually. Ooh, lead singer started up as a drummer.
That's interesting.
Eventually, the band decided he was too talented of a singer and that he should focus on that alone.
You see that? I rate that because that's letting people like, hey, you know what, for the greater, bro, you got to do this, man.
Right,
they don't care about the shine too tough like
right,
that. You're the best for the movement. Go for that.
Heather says, JB is seriously regretting this. Ha, ha, ha.
Oh, do you know what? It's not as bad as I thought it would be, but it's definitely too much of the same thing for me. Like, sonically, musically. Maybe not artistically in, like, the direction of the story that he's telling, but more just musically, sonically. It's all the same colours, same palettes, same choices. you know.
I hear that.
So it's a bit, it's a bit monotonous in that sense.
Mm.
But yeah, let's
in reference to what you said though about the sound, Phil Chertok said new Alice in Chains album sounds absolutely amazing. Sonically, some of the best recordings out there.
Interesting. That's their new album. Right. Oh. We should probably get into that another time.
Oh, there was a problem with the server.
Hold on, mine is still going.
No, we're good. We're good.
Mine is still going. And I think there was one more comment somebody said here. Do you guys agree? Shout out to Christopher Jordan. Do you guys agree this sounds like a soundtrack for someone descending into hell?
Not the literal hell.
One more comment in there as well. As an addict trying to abstain by Scott McCumber. As an addict trying to abstain is like trying to hold your breath. How long can you last? Those two comments, I think, are worth you guys commenting on.
Wow.
I wouldn't agree into a literal hell, but definitely a figurative sort of
a hell on earth.
Hell on earth.
A
hell of mind, a hell of heart. Yeah. Circumstance. Yeah.
Definitely.
That analogy of holding your breath is what it feels like to be an addict. Is it's quite interesting.
I can't help but think of the control in that, because it's you that's holding the breath.
Yeah, it is you who's holding the breath. And I think addiction is difficult, because I think we're all addicted, as you said, to something in some type of way. You know, you just got to kind of try and balance all the addictions as much as possible and not let one go too far to an extreme. Because even eating food is some people addicted and they just get crazy. Like,
this guy got me onto Red Bull, man.
I gave him an addiction. I gave him that. Oh my.
But again, days. It's just aside, it's me that buys the drink and drinks.
You know, 20th Century Refugee says Kanye is a Frankenstein monster that we all played the part in creating.
Oh yeah, we did. And I like Kanye. I like what we created. I like it. It's entertaining. He creates some good stuff. I think I'm gonna move topics, because Kanye is a very sensitive topic now. I've realized that Kanye West.
Yeah, I hear it.
He divides people.
It's connected to so many.
Yeah, so many different things.
That was a smart. There's more comments coming in though.
Oh, yes. Nah, I like this trio you got going. Says 20th.
Oh, I mean, they're 20th. Okay. You know, I think. You know,
thanks
for coming, guys. Thanks. Yeah. Yo, Malpy's got a lot to say, man. She's saying Dirt is another one of my top tracks.
You said we missed a song.
Go back and listen to the song Dirt, because you missed it.
Go back and listen to the song Dirt, because you games. Missed it.
I don't think I did.
She's going to pull up to the spot, mate.
She's putting emojis with the tears. You know, that's Heather. That's Heather's she's like a Maryland
station.
Well,
to be fair. Oh, she is. She is.
You better pull up and listen to Mal, then, man.
Do you know what? Yeah, maybe we listen to Dirt last, because we have actually heard Dirt before.
Oh, really?
We've got a reaction, us listening to Dirt. Maybe I'll make that the last one.
Oh, okay.
Let it swirl.
Angry Chair. Is that Angry Chair, the name of the next song? Angry Chair.
Wasn't that your favorite?
Oh, yes.
Thing?
That's my favorite.
Cool. That's my favorite. Wow.
You can hear it.
This is what he's doing. Sitting on it. What do I see across the way? This is where you're late. This is exactly where you're late.
This is, I don't know.
Yeah, this is about the
we
I like that contrast of a chorus. One sounds kind of happy, while the other one sounds very.
This is your song. Finished like a second.
It is
bro.
Finished, bro. It is finished.
Thankfully.
Thank God. Bruv. Don't.
Cut the thing, nope. Bruv. Dead it, bruv.
Bruv. Oh, what the?
Yes.
That... We have not completed the album.
He's going to play it in like 3 seconds.
We have not completed the album. You have failed the mission. You have failed the mission.
I'll tell you what I'm going to do.
Hold on, I thought Wood was on
song.
This.
Yeah, we've got one more song. We've got. Oh yeah, Wood is on this. We've got Wood. I think I did Wood. We did Wood.
We don't do that, bro. Come on.
Have we done Wood though?
Yes, we have done Wood.
Okay, cool. And we've done Dirt.
And we have done.
All right, we'll listen. We'll re-listen. This will be interesting.
What, the whole. The what we're gonna listen to that?
No. We've got two songs left, but we've done these songs before.
What do you think of Angry Chair?
That was terrible.
You didn't like Angry Chair?
That was terrible.
Yeah, I'm with JB on that, man. I like the melody. That was terrible. Like,
honestly speaking, this is me. I've been very nice today.
Damn.
I've been very, very nice
today. They didn't like Angry Chair.
I don't like the narrative because the whole album is going to be speaking about his addiction. This one, he was speaking to his addiction. It just got a bit too, you know, too weird for me at that point.
I think from a musical musician standpoint, yeah, it's a little bit one-dimensional, this album, musically. I'm not talking about subject matter. Subject matter is fantastic. Writing ability is great. It's good. I'm talking about musical execution and using different colors to create different images. It's like you're using the same scene to imagine doing a movie, but you're only in one room. It's like, yo, we want to see different things in the background. Like, give us some more color. It's always the same timbre. It's the same type of sound sonically. And that's fine. It's fine for an album to keep the continuity of the album consistent. But at the same time, you can branch out a little bit more, be a bit more experimental in terms of different sounds and stuff. It just sounds too monotonous. You know, it sounds like one big song.
I hear you.
It sounds too monotonous for me, you know. But I'm not going to give my final verdict. So that is my final verdict anyway. I'm not even going to cap. That's my final verdict. Bro. It's great. Now knowing the context of everything, I do appreciate it more.
Mm-hmm.
There were parts where I've enjoyed the album, listening to it so far. But it's from a musician, composer standpoint, it's just too two-dimensional. There isn't enough
valleys. There's not enough lows. The lows are not low enough in terms of sonically, in terms of bringing it down, quiet, bring you in, drawing you in. Dun, 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 dun. There's no, you know, bring me in and then take me up. It's just this mid-range.
What can we say? We all knew that JB would probably have this stance on that.
It's just that the whole way through. It's like, that's cool. Yo,
that's mad. How can you summarize that?
Bro, look.
It's good. No. It's, don't get me, no, don't get me wrong.
Do it one more time, please. yo, angry chair, you know.
I'm angry, no, bro.
Hey, don't be
no,
an angry chair. Don't be
right. No, I'm not angry. I am not on the angry chair, my bro.
Are you sure? I'm your angry chair right now. Look, don't be an angry chair, bro.
I'm just gonna read the comments and I'm gonna see what they're saying. All right,
that killed me.
That was my song.
All right.
That's JB's album. Still, I'll support the thing, bro. That's too much. Oh my goodness.
Christopher Jordan said that's an incredible impression.
Angry chair, yo, angry chair. Oh my days. People are saying yes, angry chair. Raw, that might be a new name, you know. Angry chair.
I think that's the straw that broke the camel's back for me.
The angry chair.
That song just was like, oh, loud.
Whatever says I can appreciate that critique, and you are correct. Woo! Sometimes you only need to see one room in a movie. Jerry Cantrell, second best songwriter at the late 90s, early 2000s.
I wouldn't go that far.
Behind Rage Against the Machine.
No, I wouldn't go that far.
Yeah, but the thing is, I mean, obviously, yes, I would say in the context of
Rage,
the music,
Zach De La Rocha,
yes,
songwriting,
yes,
give
bro.
Me a break.
No, hold up. In Cap. Lyric content. Cap. No, wait.
If we're talking about the subject matter, yes. Right. But if we're talking about the actual delivery and the actual... No, it's bollocks,
no,
bro.
No. I mean...
Oh, my gosh.
You don't think he's got it?
Zach De La Rocha. Songwriting ability. No. I feel like the music carries him on their back.
I feel like
the Rage Band are the bloody... The Shark. And then... Zach is the penguin on top of the shark's back, surfing. Just get hitching a ride, bro.
No.
I don't agree with that.
Do you hear this take?
That's slightly
better.
With two AK-47s in his hand. Wait, hold on.
Yeah. If you're saying that then, because you know there is a band where Zach is out and they put somebody else in, right? Prophets of Rage. You heard?
I haven't heard Prophets of Rage.
You have, because we did a reaction to it and you've forgotten. But, okay.
I think I was there for that
one. Yeah, you were there for that one.
Prophets of Rage.
Did you?
I did.
Did you?
No, I did.
Actually, you know what? That is funny, because that's what I was remembering now. Right. He dissed them. He said... It sounds very like...
Yes, he did.
You did something like that.
That's Rage Against the Machine.
You've done another song like that.
Who was talking? Who's the front man for Prophet?
It was B-Roll from Cypress Hill and Chuck D from Public Enemy.
Okay, hold on.
Sorry. I know we are on a... Alice in Chains. I'm just going to make this point and we're going to go on to the next two songs, right?
There's two more songs.
Yes, I know. Right. What was I going to say? Then in that case, why do you have an issue with Audio Slave?
I like Audio Slave.
No, you don't like Audio Slave. Look at every...
I do like Audio Slave.
Look at every
Black
review.
Hole Sun.
No, that's Soundgarden.
Oh, flipping hell.
Audio Slave, every reaction we've done to Audio Slave, which is basically the band of Rage Against the Machine with Chris Cornell from Soundgarden, you have disliked.
No, I've liked the song. I didn't like what what's his face? Tom Morello was doing on the song. But anyway, let's move on.
Right.
Wood.
Christopher Jordan said he had a go. Lads and chatters, this has been an amazing start to my Saturday, but I have to drop. Much love, have a great weekend. And
see you later, my man. See you later, my man.
Big up yourself, Christopher Jordan.
Thank you for joining us, guys.
Sorry about angry chair over here.
'Oh,
he just doesn't like the style of music.
I just don't like the style of music, mate.
I can just hear John Boy's impression. You've just ruined the last two songs.
By the way, I do like this song because we've performed it. We performed it, didn't we? Did we actually perform it at Abbey Roads?
No.
Oh, we didn't. We were going to.
We did it here a few times.
Oh, yeah, right, right. Into the blood again. I like this song.
Really?
Yeah. 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 What can you guys see when you hear this song? Because I can see myself on a motorbike. It's like sunset and I'm cruising, wearing a leather jacket, and there's a hot girl on the back of my motorbike.
Oh, wow.
I'm just cruising. What can you guys see?
I'm walking home drunk through the park. Just trying to get home, like, put my hood up, and I'm there paranoid, like, raw. Why is that bush looking like a bush, like? Is that a nice place?
There's that, again. Yeah, he loves that note, doesn't he? He loves a little wobbly note, don't he?
That's a signature, man, you know?
But this is making for a strong closing of an album, though.
Oh, yeah. It is great.
Taking up, making up for a strong closing for of an album. You come out of Mellowland.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, my bad. That is definitely a close.
That is a great. That's a close to album.
That is a close.
Do you know what? Let's go straight into Dirt, and that's the last song. So we just, and then we can talk about the album. Get out of here. Do our thing.
Comments are going crazy.
Ooh. So this ain't the last song, is it?
No, the other Wood was the last song.
Okay. Wood was the one that we just listened to.
Yeah.
So this is the second last.
No. This was, we missed it at top. Okay. You can hear it.
It's just hard. Like, I just don't care.
Yeah.
Yeah, just take me out. Were here the whole time?
Yeah. You can feel it?
Obviously I can't, because look how you're holding it.
I mean, it was just down there, you know what I mean?
Damn.
I went, that's why I'm trying to bring it up so it can
move. Yeah, yeah. That's bit. What you were doing when I said that you have a heated angry chair.
Struggling, yeah.
Oh wow. Wherever says, thank you guys. It might sound bad, but it actually reminds me of why I'm as strong as I am in my life. Oh wow, really?
What's that?
Oh, but before that, he said, I don't know why, but this song brings me to tears every time I listen to it.
Oh man.
Oh, man. Which one, Wood or this song?
What? No, I think he's saying, I think he said that for what? This for this song. You said whatever. You said it for this song, right? Our era was an escape for a lot of us, right, in a certain age bracket. It reminds me of being picked up, being picked on at school.
Ooh.
But then I could go home in my room and put this music on and escape for a bit. I hear that.
Wow.
I hear that.
Charles used to be picked on for the gap in his tooth.
Yeah, he still is, to be fair. Mm. Broke up on the way here.
This never happened. This is a strange narrative.
It's making up Charles's memories. You know, yeah, whatever, just confirmed it was this song.
Okay.
This is nice.
That's nice solo. There are no more guitar solos in songs, have you noticed? There's no more guitar solos in songs. There's no more solos in songs. They don't solo no more. Give me one song on the radio that has a solo in it.
I have to give you a radio song first. I don't know when I last listened to radio.
Well, I hear that. Everything's TikTok.
Gotta say, this is my least favorite Alice in Chains song.
Fair.
Yeah. I think maybe because I just overheard it.
Right.
There's some songs like that. But saying that, I overheard Wood, and I still, that song still gets me. You know what I mean?
Fair play.
Phil Shertuk also said radio songs also rarely have a bridge either.
Yeah, they don't have a bridge.
And Uncle Fatty been going mad in the comments. He said, I don't know anything. I don't know anything. I don't know who to Uncle Fatty. I don't know who to be. One can truly feel Alice in Chains without imagining the prick of the needle and the depression that comes with it. So what he's saying is that I don't have to walk through the road because this artist has articulated that road so well for me.
That is very...
Uncle Fatty, is that what you're saying?
Wow. That is actually very deep.
Whatever. There's a difference between your buddies effing with you and bullies in school. I can rise my buds and they can rise me really hard. It's something we do to each other as men. Yeah. We just taking a mick out of Charlie Boy. Yeah.
Sorry, guys.
Bullies.
And this song ends. Oh, my days. Angry chair.
Okay. That is the album, guys.
We've done it.
That is the album.
The first full reaction review to an album. The first of many.
How do you feel? I feel cold.
Yeah, it's cold. And can we get some Chinese food?
Yeah.
Run this?
Yeah. After this?
Yeah.
Just walk down there?
Yeah, come.
All right, bro. What are you telling me?
Do you know what? I'll sum it up very quickly, very briefly. This album is six tuplets that have been birthed into the world. Six tuplets, six of them. These are six tuplet twins. And they've grown up to be hot women. And I've been introduced to them. And I've just realized I don't need them all. I could just take one. This whole album is like the same thing over and over again. It's a bunch of girls that look exactly the same. Let me take her and her.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe her. And I'm good. Like, I don't need the whole album. I don't need all the songs.
Okay.
Because they... they kind of go over the same subject matter.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And then number two, sonically, just musically, from a musical standpoint, it's kind of like, it's the same palette. So it got very boring very quickly. Not to say that I didn't enjoy the little selections that I got, but I don't want 12, 13 songs of this, of the same thing, you know. For me personally, I like variety. But again, if I was in a way and I was in a very dark place, or I was, you know, wanting some comfort, you know, I would definitely slap this on and listen to it for the for an hour and a bit, or 50 minutes. I'll just be like, yeah, hit me. But yeah, that's my opinion. Great selections of songs. Don't need it too much. It's just too much. Condense it.
I agree with some of the things you're saying. I do think that there is some. I think some of the. I think most of the songs need time. You need to sit with it. You know, it needs to be something that some. A lot of them are growers. You know, it's not. That album to me wasn't exactly a great. I didn't attach myself to the album quickly. Like, you know, it wasn't. It was. It took some time because one, it's not. It's melodic in certain songs, but overall, the palette is not really a melodic album in that sort of way. You know, obviously it messes with strange kind of off key sort of melodies and lyrics and everything like that, and so on and so on. So it's one that you really need to take your time with.
Right, yeah, okay, fair.
That's what I would honestly say. That's what it is. But I think it is a great album once you do dedicate and soak in it.
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, be careful of not overly taking it.
Soaking, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, not overly sinking soaking. In it. Yeah, no sinking. Yeah, just... Yeah, take it easy.
I get it.
Take it easy.
Yeah.
But yeah, go on.
I'd say, yeah, it's not advisable to listen to this when you are really going through it. I don't, you know, I don't think so.
Maybe it is, and maybe a little bit for therapy.
I think it depends,
a little bit of therapy depends.
How far you're in that feeling stage, you know. But yeah, I think the album's cool, man. I think the album's cool. I like the choppiness of it, in the sense that there's so many transitions, so many different, the song can go here, kind of thing. It is samey, as you said, though, in terms of narrative. But I'm not going to lie, that sameness is off-weighted or off-balanced by the you know, the schooling that the live people gave us about, you know, the heroin, the drugs, the Vietnam, and the da-da-da.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I think it's cool. I don't know if I'd listen to it a lot. I might download one or two tunes to my phone.
Yeah.
Listen to it when I'm on a long train journey.
Yeah.
But it's not my an everyday.
Yeah.
And that's got nothing to do with the genre or style of music. I'm into it. I mess with it heavy. Mm. But
you wouldn't want to be in that place mentally every day.
Lad, you're just talking about, you know.
Definitely,
you
know,
addiction and you're this and you're that. And there's a comment here actually that I wanted to go to by whatever. Primus Pork Soda is the album. Check it out. I listened to that as a tape over.
Primus?
No. Sorry, it was 20th Century Refugee. Alice in Chains, lyrics have a lot of commiserating attached to them. It was this part in particular. People would listen and feel like someone understood whatever struggle they were going through. And I think that is what you're talking about, the sinking aspect of it. Because you don't have to be going through something that they're going through. But because you feel like you're understood by them, you can really just get kind of pulled into some next thing.
So your trauma attaching, you're attaching to their trauma.
Trauma bonding. Attaching, all of that. Yeah, man. Yeah, you know. Definitely. So that's why I think you should leave this room right now.
Look, bro. Let me tell you something.
Anyway. What are we rating the album out of 10, fellas? Out of 10. 10 being unattainable, because I think nothing's perfect.
8? Wow, that's
I'll give it 8. But I'm not coming from... the I think we need to standpoint.
Really have a score as well. Like,
okay, you know, cool. We can do that.
I wouldn't come from my one is more narrative based as opposed to musical, musically. Though it's all samey.
Yeah.
It's the fact that, you know, you've articulated your addiction. You've articulated the highs, the lows, and that's also including that one song I didn't like.
Yeah.
Where it's the only song I feel like they're talking straight to the addiction. as opposed to about the addiction.
But rate it on, you had to listen to this from start to finish, I'm on the train, that whole experience, not just the narrative, like in its entirety, what would you give it? Like pacing, was it too much? Was it too much?
No, if you're asking for that, then it's gonna have to be a 6 still.
6?
Yeah. 6, okay.
What about you, Zando?
I'll probably give it 6.5, 7.
Okay.
I'll end on 7.
7.
Yeah.
Is that including your nostalgia though? Because you've got that kind of thing to it as well.
It's true. But the thing is, like I said, I do have that nostalgia to it. Mm. But you know what? No, I'm actually gonna go back 6.5 because
we don't do halves.
It's just either full number or that's it.
All right. Fine. We don't do halves. 6.
Okay. Cool.
I will say that because when the good songs came in, the songs that I liked the most, you really saw the contrast to the other songs.
Yeah, 100%. Right. I agree.
So when Wood came up, it was like whoa, night and day. And I don't think albums should fully be like that.
No.
But even though I do appreciate the other songs, but still. So I would say 6.
Right. Cool. It's a strong 4.
Wow.
Strong. Okay. Like healthy 4.
Can't say I'm surprised.
Good 4. It was too long for me. Too much of the same thing. It wasn't too long. It could be longer, but it was too much of the same thing. The journey felt like it wasn't a roller coaster. It was like a really, really, really slow, like being on a conveyor belt at the airport. Just like, and then you get to the end. It's like, oh, I have moved. There were a couple good songs in it, but it weren't enough to save the whole project for me. The subject matter was cool, and I agree with the 20th century when he said, you know, you can kind of attach your trauma to it and kind of live through it in different ways. But just as an album, it was a 4 for me. As an album, it was a 4.
I'm writing down the score.
I'm not going to lie, the score's not looking healthy because out of 30, it's 10, 10, 10. I saw Charles added up.
Mm. Yeah,
and that's not a good score, bro.
So what is it? What is it?
16.
Get on? It gets a 16 out of 30.
So that's a D, bro.
That's like a D. It's half above halfway, isn't it?
Yeah, you got a D, bro.
Okay,
50-something%.
A D.
All right. Cool.
Okay.
All right.
Wow.
All right,
guys.
What are the people saying?
Guys, out of 10, what is your rating for this album, start to finish?
Also, what album do you guys want us to do next?
Someone said the Colindale tape. Oh, and someone said the Sincerely Me tape as well. These are my projects.
Excalibur.
Yeah, I know.
You don't know Excalibur. Excalibur does his digging on Charles.
Oh.
He's a guy that he would say something like that. He would dig and be like, yeah.
Excalibur, I need you. Come, Excalibur. Save my. Yeah. Best MTV Unplugged performance ever. Back in the day when I had hair, I was dark and purple with the little Billy Goat scruff. I was talking about Kurt Cobain's best album, MTV Unplugged performance.
Mm. We're looking for albums, my guy.
Yeah, guys, you know, the Colindale tape, it's an elusive project. And it's been highly sought after, but they can't find it. I have found it, though.
Where's the MStat tape?
It's coming, though. I promise it's coming. The whole last year, our studio got robbed. So I wasn't able to do anything musically. But everything has been, I've recorded MStat on my side, it's done.
Okay.
So it's good. You should see it this side of the year, bro.
I would love to hear it.
Would you do a reaction? Yeah, there you go. See, now you're doing your thing again. Now you're going back to John Boy. He said MStat. I said, alright baby, it's gonna be a couple of months, I'll get it cooked. You're gonna do a review.
I need to hear it, man. I don't even we was in different places.
Listen to it live, innit? Listen to it live.
Boy.
The MStat tape, okay, can I speak about the MStat tape? For the viewers, everyone that's live, the MStat tape is a project that we're making
did.
A face.
I don't we, want we did together. the collab we did together.
We did. We all did a collaborative project together, and it's amazing. Yeah. These guys produced it. They done amazing.
My favorite song is called Alcohol and Drugs. We've got a song called Alcohol and Drugs that I really like. Mm. Very playful. It's very playful. I did enjoy those times. It was good. Do you know what?
There's a can I call it a drum solo? A drum
solo by
JB.
On the outro
to one of my, it's one of my favorite pieces on the whole tape, actually, Ferris Wheel. Oh. The drum solo that you do on the outro of that is amazing. I love that. And the guitar, just what you were doing on Money Ain't a Thing is just dumb. Money, but anyway, we got a tape. Hopefully it's going to be coming out this year. And I would love for these guys. I would love to come back, actually.
I would rate it a 3.
What? You haven't even heard it.
I do, actually.
Don't mind him. Don't mind him.
You're just a hater.
Anyway, let's get on focus. Let's get on focus, people. So
Uncle Fatty is talking up a storm.
Mad season. Okay, all right. You know what? Look, we'll make an announcement on the next one. We'll
Operation Ivy as well. You've got the
Operation Ivy.
Operation Ivy. Oh, well. The
origins of rock.
The punk band. The legendary punk band. Okay, okay.
Someone said, check out Tom Waits' album, Rain Dogs. It's a far cry from grunge, but I'm curious to hear what you think. That's from 20th Century Refugee. Uncle Fatty came back again with check out Hell Roy's. I don't do no drugs on the Hell Roy's Are Real album.
We'll announce.
But we'll thank announce. You guys, as thank usual, you. For tuning in. Thank you to Indipal Sandu over there. Give your socials and all your social medias.
Indipal Sandu. Just, Indipal please, Sandu. Just check me out.
Thank you, Charles, for being on time. You're on time today.
That's
you were on time.
Today.
That,
I'm not gonna lie,
that does need a thank you.
And thank you, JB, for
tolerating.
Yes, you do, bro. For, you know, being patient and getting through this album that I knew would be a struggle for your little brain.
I need to vomit.
Wow.
I need to go
one more time. One more time. We need to do your version of the album.
Hey, I forgot the song. Damn. Hey, I forgot it.
Can we get the angry chair impression from you one more time as well? That was really good. The whole.
I don't. No, I'm not. Yeah, I'm
no, the
angry. No, you're not getting that.
Okay,
bro.
Thank